Now, medical science offers you proof positive. Yes, medical science offers you proof positive.
Cigarette is safer to smoke because no other gives you less nicotine, less throat-irritating tars than the new, smoother, better-tasting Raleigh.
Singing star Anita Ellis, Gigi Pearson, Verna Felton, Pat McGeehan, and yours truly, Rod O'Connor. It's a pleasure to bring you Metro-Goldwyn-Mayer's popular comedian and the star of the Raleigh Cigarette Program, Red Skelton.
Ladies and gentlemen, I feel great tonight. I saw Bob Hope over in Griffith Park selling benches today.
I'm proud of that. That ain't in here.
How are you tonight, Mr. O'Connor?
Oh, a little tired from trying to outsmart the 1st of April pranksters, Red. Tell me, did you get fooled much?
Yeah, I started the day off by unwrapping a big package that I was in. Somebody played another dirty trick. They called up and said the butcher had butter, see, but I didn't go down to the butcher store.
Well, what was the dirty trick?
He had butter. Oh, I would like to thank whoever sent me that pound of butter. I got a pound of butter, you know.
Really?
Yeah.
Someone sent you a pound of butter?
Yep. And me and the mailman had quite a spread, see. The butter was melted. But we didn't let it go to waste, see. We had toast, postcards, and coffee.
Speaking of butchers, I see the OPA is up the price of pork and ham.
Yeah.
You gonna ask for a raise?
I might. You can get more money, too. Beef was included in that.
Fat boy?
Fat boy? Well.
He's toting enough soap in that pot to clean up the nation, no? Why don't you get out of the meat market and give yourself up, Rod? Or didn't you know there was a fattage of short? I mean, a short...
Just stick with it. It's there. All you have to do is read it,
yes,
you know.
I... keep on. We may spare the rod tonight, you know. Don't call me no... I know ham, you know. Hams can be cured, you know. Hi, Anita.
Oh, I read in the April issue of Screenland magazine that you're quite a hunter. Is that true?
Oh, I usually find things, yes.
Well, you know, Anita, I'm handy with a gun. How'd you like to see me shoot a cigarette out of Skelton's mouth?
Whose mouth? After me calling you fat boy? Oh, no. You'll drop a short round on me, boy.
Don't be silly. I used to do that act in vaudeville.
Vaudeville's dead, and I ain't going to ask it to move over.
Oh, yes, I do.
Well, I could fall in love with a big, brave hunter.
You could, huh? Well, you know, one night I was out hunting, and I see a big black thing, and I blasted away with it with my old rusty .45.
Trusty.
Rusty. I got caught in the California weather. Well, anyhow, after I shoot, I throw my flashlight on it, and it's a big bear. He was dead.
No long. Yeah. How long did you take it?
Yes, you did it all by yourself. Would you like to try it again? There was a big bear and he was dead.
No kidding. How long do you figure it had been dead?
Don't do much good after it died, does it?
Equipment.
Yeah, I have everything but a dog and someone who can read a script. I have. Look, I had a dog once, but he was gun shy. I fired the gun over his head, and 3 days later he come back and he says, "What's all the shooting for?"
Now, medical science offers you proof positive. Yes, medical science offers you proof positive.
No other leading cigarette is safer to smoke because no other gives you less nicotine, less throat-irritating tars than the new, smoother, better-tasting Raleigh.
Yes, scientific tests of America's 6 biggest-selling brands based on a method used by the United States government. Tests certified by a jury of 14 distinguished doctors, including throat specialists, have proved conclusively. No other cigarette gives you less nicotine, less throat-irritating tars, so no other is safer to smoke. Yes, Raleigh's are right. Right for taste, right for throat. Enjoy Raleigh's rich tobaccos, that smoother, more satisfying Raleigh flavor. Remember, medical science offers you proof positive.
No other cigarette is safer to smoke because no other gives you less nicotine, less throat-irritating tars than the new, smoother, better-tasting Raleigh.
And now Frank Ellis's little girl Anita will sing Laughing on the Outside. Skelton's scrapbook of satire, we find a story entitled Some People Just Won't Pay Their Debt. Our characters are fictional. If there's any similarity to persons living, it's not only a coincidence, but an impossibility. Chapter 108 is entitled Where's That Money You Owe Me? If you borrow more money than you can afford to pay back, either you're very stupid or Clem, the fella from the country.
Thank you.
tired today. It took me 4 hours to eat my lunch. I got to stop eating those bubblegum sandwiches. Sure, I'm in the chips now. I just got my paycheck, $20. I owe 50 of it, though. Don't leave me very much, you know. Good heavens, there's Keith McCloud, the guy I owe some money to. I'll just pull my ears over my face so he won't recognize me. So I got a run in one of my ears. Don't go on things not out of rayon, is it? Thanks, you put too much starch in them.
Hey, you crab!
Uh-oh, he spotted me. I better scoot my footsies around the corner here. Old Graham Crackers, here he comes.
Just a minute, you.
Howdy doody.
I want to talk to you, cadaddlehopper.
Cadiddlehopper. That's what it says on my pedigree papers, isn't it? It's like grasshopper, only there's a cadiddle in it.
What about my money?
What money?
Look, don't play dumb with me.
With me, I ain't playing. I'm always this way. What's on your mind, if any?
I want to know when you're going to pay me that dollar that you owe me.
Here, now let go of me now. Let go of my throat. Stop squeezing my Adam's apple, will you?
Well, I ain't squeezing your Adam's apple hard.
Oh, no? Well, come on. We're suddenly making taste cider.
Look, either you pay me my money or I'm going to knock your block off.
Well, now, I'm not going to stand for this.
Oh, no?
I told you I wasn't going to stand for it. Good thing I was born numb from the neck up, you know.
I'm tired of fooling with you, Clem.
Yes?
I'm coming back in 10 minutes, and you better have that money, or I'm going to take it out of your hide.
How'd you find out where I kept it? I better hurry home. That's what I better do. Open up.
And just look why you're a-wearing shoes.
Them ain't shoes. I stepped in some fresh cement this morning.
Well, where did you get that black eye? It just looks awful.
Well, it's going to look better soon because I'm going to have a broken neck to match it.
Oh, Clem. Clem, you talk nonsense.
And I phrase it well, too.
Tell me what happened.
Well, some feller claims he owed me a dollar, and just because I won't pay him back, he got sore.
Why, that's ridiculous.
I got a bang out of it myself.
Well, are you going to pay
him? If I don't, he's going to look me up at my block off.
Why, that's awful.
Oh, well, now, don't worry. My head's unbreakable, you know.
Oh, Clem, you're the most stupid man I know.
Well, now, that's mighty nice of you. I'm glad you appreciate me, Sarah Dew. Uh-oh, he's followed me here.
Well, run upstairs and hide, Clem.
Okay, too late, he saw me. Yeah.
All right, I caught you, didn't I?
Yeah.
I thought you'd pull the old brake. Are you going to pay me?
I am not. I'm going to run upstairs and hide, and you can't stop me. Let's go with my suspenders, will you?
Remember, medical science offers you proof positive. Remember, medical science offers you proof positive. No other leading cigarette is safer to smoke because no other gives you less nicotine, less throat-irritating tars than the new, smoother, better-tasting Raleigh. Hank Greenberg, Detroit Tigers home run king, says, quote,
no hocus-pocus here. I've read the reports. Medical science has proved no other cigarette gives you less nicotine, less throat-irritating tars. Thus, no other is safer to smoke. Knowing the facts, I recommend Raleigh's. Raleigh's are right.
Right, Hank Greenberg. And those tests were based on a method used by the United States government. So enjoy Raleigh's rich tobaccos, that more satisfying Raleigh flavor. Remember, medical science offers you proof positive.
No other cigarette is safer to smoke because no other gives you less nicotine, less throat-irritating tars than the new, smoother, better-tasting Raleigh.
David Forrester and his orchestra featuring Don Ferris at the piano will play excerpts from Rachmaninoff's Concerto No. 2, theme of Frank Brzezinski's Technicolor production, I've Always Loved You. Chapter 109 of the Skeleton Scrapbook is entitled Run and Hide, the Bill Collector's Coming. Bill collectors are broad-minded. They spare nobody. One sure way of keeping away from your door is to have someone around like Junior, the mean Widow Ken.
You heard about Jack and the Beanstalk and the goose that laid the golden fortune? Well, I am Junior, the kid with a cat. It's going to cough up a fortune. Come on, put it out.
What on earth are you talking about?
Come on, put it out, kitty. Come on, put it out.
That? It's what out?
Money. He's a little witch cat, he is. I heard Mr. Frank next door tell his wife that they could take a trip because there was $50 in the kitty. Now, if if I can only get him to fit it out, Jane.
Put that cat out before she scratches you.
If he scratches me, she'll be listed in the obituary column 9 times. Oh, look at her. Look at her licking her paw with her tongue. Look at her.
She's washing herself.
Well, do tell. I thought maybe she was straightening out her lipstick or something. All right, I'll put her outside, but she's awful widow. She'll be carrying that much money around, you know, all the crime that's going on. Hey, Grandma, what's she doing?
Sewing.
What kind of sewing?
I'm doing the whip stitch on the seat of your pants.
Always practicing, huh?
Junior, what am I going to do with you?
Running out of ideas, eh, kiddo? Hey, where's me slingshot, huh?
Are you planning something bad?
Well, you might think it's bad, but if I ain't slipping, I think it's pretty good myself. Oh, there's me slingshot. She hit it on the table there. I'll reach up and...
Junior, what did you break?
You know that vase with Whistler's mother on it?
Yes.
The old girl just had a nervous breakdown.
Well, pick up what's left of the vase and throw it in the trash can.
Yeah. Ain't you going to whip me? Ain't you going to knock me with her head off like you usually do?
No, Junior. You were truthful.
But if you don't whip me, I might do something really bad.
Now, Junior...
No. You just don't love me, that's all.
Oh, you just
don't. I want to be noticed to make no better, that's all.
That sweet, bless his little heart.
Your bloody little heart.
Well, if you insist.
No, not so hard. Goodness, I met you halfway. Be a sport, kiddo.
If you don't watch your talk, I'm going to wash your mouth out with soap.
Well, don't overdo it like the last time. I was blowing bubbles for 2 days around. Who's that?
I wonder who that could be.
I don't know.
Oh, it's the first of the month. It's the bill collector.
Bill collector? Yes. Hasn't you finished paying for me yet?
If he hadn't, he still wouldn't take you back.
Yes. Grandma, the jig is up. We is trapped like rats. Nail down the furniture. Lock the doors. Quick, hide down in the cellar.
Oh, stop acting silly.
Hey, he's been out trying to get money from us before. Look, he's got a baseball bat and a blowtorch. Look.
Now, keep quiet.
Okay.
Maybe he'll go away.
Yeah.
Keep away from the window.
Don't hit me. Commando tactics, huh? I'll infiltrate under the table here.
Be careful, Junior. That lamp. You must...
Save your breath, kiddo. I knew what you was going to say anyway.
I hear you there. I heard you knock something over. Open this door. I'm a bill collector. I'm with the Ever-Friendly Credit Company.
Boy.
What's he doing, Junior?
Wait, I'll look through the keyhole and see.
What do you see?
I can't see anything. His eye's in the way. I'm proud of that. Oh, look, there's that nutty man that lives next door there. That old Don Boomhauer. Look at him. He just came out. Look.
Good morning. Good morning. It's a little light to be looking in windows, isn't it?
I'm looking for the people who live here.
Well, in that case, you've come to the right place.
Hey, I'm going to sneak upstairs where I can get a better view. Because I'm going up the steps to make better time. I'm going to slide up the banister. A little trick I learned watching newsreels.
You know, these people are pretty sneaky. They're always hiding from me.
Well, try again. Maybe they'll answer. I saw the kid outside a while ago playing with a bear trap.
Yeah. I'm going to peep out and see what's... Oh, there he is, right beneath the window. Now, he ought to know better than that. Oh, boy. Boy, what a spot for a bag of water. Boy, shall I?
Shall I?
Me good self says no, but me bad self says yes. Yes, no, yes, no, 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 yes. Well, look at that. While me good self was jabbering away, me bad self filled up a bag. Well, I ain't gonna do it. Here it goes. Way to go.
It's clouding up.
Yeah. Now it's coming down in bags for you.
You, sir? Oh, there you are.
What are they doing now? The bill collector is walking around the side of the house. Oh, boy. Oh, boy. Oh, boy.
What are you so happy about?
He's walking into my landmine. Oh, boy. I can hardly wait.
Wait for what?
Oh!
Did that answer your question, kiddo?
What happened to him?
Well, he just found out how a bear trap works. He really put his foot old paw on that, didn't he, huh?
Junior, where did you get that bear trap?
It's the one you threw away after you caught Grandpa. Hey, why don't that man go away?
Because he's after the radio.
Yeah? Why does he work with a radio that don't work?
Since when doesn't it work?
Since you left me alone in the house this morning.
What?
Yeah?
I'm going to spank you.
Shh, you can't. The man's still down there.
Oh, that's dirty. Right.
Yeah, that's a pretty good thing. I wish he'd stay around a couple of weeks. Give the sheet of me pants time to cool off.
Oh, he's sneaking in the back door. We're lost.
Good afternoon. Quite a fortress you've got here.
Yeah. Ah, we like it, we guys.
I want to apologize. I'm ashamed of the way we treated you.
Well, you should be. I think we've got a kick coming.
Oh, yes, and you're going to get it, too.
Oh, she kicked my shin.
Junior, stop kicking the man. You've got your good shoes on.
Yeah.
Aren't you ashamed of yourself?
What?
Aren't you ashamed of yourself?
I certainly is. Yeah. He's still standing up.
I'm taking this radio right now unless you care to pay the sum of $100.
I don't have it.
Hold out, Joe.
Yeah. Hurry out, Joe. Hey, wait a minute. Don't hang your toe up. I got some bananas hidden there.
Easy does it going down the steps, Joe.
Yeah, I'm not going to sit here and eat a banana on the steps. Wouldn't it be awful if they accidentally stepped on a banana peel? I wonder if I laid a banana peel here, they would step on it. Or maybe they would step over it. And then again, I don't know why I'm sitting here with my tongue hanging out. I'm going to do it anyhow. I just laid it down here real easy, and maybe they won't see it now.
Look out now. Here's the first step, Joe.
Surprised you, didn't they?
Well, here we are at the bottom. Easy now.
That was me delayed action banana peel.